We've talked a lot about the growth of artificial intelligence on this program, from the bias of facial recognition software used by law enforcement to the impact of deep fakes, videos used to spread misinformation and potentially influence democracy. Annie Dorsen is pushing the limits of artificial intelligence even further. She's pioneered a new genre of theater that's challenging human and non-human communication and putting AI center stage. Take a look.
Do you like Steely Dan?
I love Steely Dan.
Are you real and in the ears?
I do not know whether I am real and in the ears. I am encased in a box.
Just kidding.
H-A-H-A-H-A-H-A-H-A.
That's from her 2010 piece, Hello, Hi There. Her work just won a grant from the MacArthur Foundation, which is also known as the Genius Award. Annie, it's so nice to have you. Congratulations on being a genius.
Thank you very much. Well, I don't know if I'm going to accept that.
Yes, but I will accept on your behalf. Okay, you are. You get to call yourself a genius from now till into perpetuity. How would you describe your work? Because in the clip we showed, I'm sure our audience is like, that's weird theater.
Right. It doesn't look like normal theater because the first thing you notice is there's no actors. But I started doing this kind of thing in 2010, working with computer programmers to sort of generate theater where computers or computer algorithms would perform alongside or even instead of human actors.
Are you a technologist? I mean, do you come at this from like a tech perspective or from a theater perspective?
From a theater perspective. I was trained as a theater director, and I did, you know, plays with actors and scripts and the whole, you know, sort of normal way for many years. And I started working with computer programmers back in 2010. So I don't do any of the coding. I mean, I've picked up a lot over the years, but basically I think more, I don't know, conceptually about how information technologies are changing the way people live together and how we live actually with computers.
So, often theater directors, right, will take human beings and have them have conversations or have something impact their lives as we watch it on the stage unfold. They don't make the technology center stage.
Yeah, right.
Why did you look at it that way?
Well, I started thinking about how much we're adapting the way we live to the needs of computers. That's something that I think a lot of, you know, media theorists have pointed out.
Give me an example.
I mean, just really in a basic level, you know, people now sit in front of a computer all day doing their work. We learn the language of computer programs. We start to communicate with each other via these machines. They structure our, you know, not only our mode of communication, but they also are the windows we have into the world. So what we know about the world, to a large extent, is becoming really dependent on how algorithms present that information to us.
So what were you hoping to explore?
In traditional theater, you know, there's lines and they're written by a playwright, and we think we're learning something about the character's inner life, their desires, right, their motivation. And I started thinking, well, if a computer is generating that language, you know, a computer has no desire. There's no inner life. It's a kind of a flatness to it. And yet at the same time, the language has an impact. Mm. So this is one of the sort of classic questions of computer science going back all the way to 1950 is, can you program a computer to have a conversation that sounds like a human conversation?
What is the takeaway then? What would you say that you've learned from 2010 to now about kind of the value, the impact, the risks of AI?
Yeah, I mean, I think it goes back to actually what you said in the introduction, that we think about AI in the political realm as something that we have to be very careful of. And I think, you know, what I'd like to propose is that we also can be thinking and reflecting about AI also in the social and emotional realm, sort of the psychological realm as well, that these tools have a lot of power, and we're starting to entangle with them more and more. These are powerful things. And in theater, we're used to telling stories. These algorithms also tell stories.
Do you lord over your friends that you're a genius? Like, do you make them? Well, that's a very fair question, and I thought that would be the answer. Well, just saying, make them call you genius.
You know, it's only been a few days since I've
A few days you've been wasting. Come on. The genius, Annie Dorsen, with us. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
We appreciate it.